10 years, they just sort of like, they'll be back.
Yeah, so I thought it was part of those like.
This is Spaceship Earth Control. On behalf of Stevens, welcome aboard. Now locate the monitor overhead to the right. Make sure your face is clearly visible and wait for the flash.
Sending photos to the future.
All systems are go. Linking now to your guide.
Like a grand and miraculous spaceship, you all have signaled to the time. And for a brief moment, we have been among these passengers. But where are we going? And what kind of future will we discover there? Surprisingly, the answers lie in our past.
Thank you.
am Audrey.
Travelers, please remain seated. Your time machine is rotating backward for your return to Earth.
Welcome to the diversity and the often surprising nature of living with the land. Our journey begins as dramatic and sudden changes are sweeping over the land. The approaching storm may seem violent and destructive to us, but to nature, it's a new beginning in the cycle of life. Precious nutrients and minerals. These elements, when combined with sunlight, create the diverse living systems of our planet. Those living systems is the rainforest, home to the most amazing concentration of life on our planet. These dense and beautiful forests cover only a tiny portion of the Earth's surface, but they contain more than half of its plant and animal species. Rainforests are also extremely rich in productive living systems, providing us with oxygen, food, medicines, and other elements essential to our lives. In the desert, nature has created a very different, no less beautiful, living system. And while this arid landscape may seem lifeless, it is very much alive. The plants and animals that have learned to survive in these harsh conditions make use of what little water they can find and avoid the scorching rays of the relentless sun. The American prairie once appeared as desolate as the desert, but over time, rainwater and nutrients gradually penetrated the hard surface of this land. Even the hooves of the mighty buffalo helped create the rich soil that would one day become home to the American farm. Forces at work on the land, humans have had one of the most profound effects. The need to produce food for a growing world led to the enormous use and sometimes overuse of the land. In our search for more efficient ways to grow food, we often fail to realize the impact of our methods. Today, we're learning to live with the land, discovering better ways to grow food that will assure both human and environmental well-being.
Our soil, we can reduce the need for fertilizers. In farmlands across America, we're learning that by plowing up vegetation containing natural fertilizers, we can enrich the soil without the use of chemicals. In Saudi Arabia and Mexico, we're learning
how will we meet tomorrow's growing needs for food production, yet still respect the needs of the land? Some of the answers are being discovered just ahead. To help us maintain these carefully controlled ecosystems, and for your safety, please remain seated in your boat at all times. Laboratories where scientists from Epcot and the U.S. Department of Agriculture are exploring innovative ways to produce bountiful harvests now and into the future. The tropics are home to the greatest diversity of plants on the planet. Many of these, like papaya, bananas, cacao, coffee, and rice, are well known around the world. These are just a few of the edible plants that have been an important source of nutrition for people living in the tropics. Many are rich in vitamins and minerals, while others are well adapted to growing in less than ideal conditions. Some, like the water lily, thrive in wet, swampy areas and waterways. All parts of this plant, even the flower petals, are edible. The starchy root of the plant has long been used to make flour for baking. One day, many of these lesser-known tropical plants may be as important as the bananas growing on both sides of the boat. More than 28 million tons of bananas are eaten annually, making it the most popular fruit in the world. Farming. You probably don't think of fish, but fish farming, or aquaculture, accounts for nearly half of all the seafood consumed globally. Tilapia, bass, and catfish, like the ones you see here, are three of the more popular crops raised by fish farmers. The sustainable system we're using here recycles the water in the tanks. As a result, we're able to save millions of gallons each year. Our small fish farm produces nearly 5,000 pounds of fish each year to serve in restaurants around Walt Disney World. Innovations like this one can play an important role in our efforts to produce bountiful harvests and still protect natural resources. While there are more than 50,000 edible plant species in the world, most of us are only familiar with the handful that make up our everyday diet. The common grains growing here, wheat, maize, sorghum, and millet, plus rice, account for nearly two-thirds of our global food consumption. Learning how to increase yields of these staples is an important goal of research around the world. These plants are definitely on their way up. Innovative growing techniques like these increase yields while more efficiently using resources like water, fertilizer, and pesticides. Another innovation at work here is our integrated pest management program. By populating our greenhouses with beneficial insects that prey on harmful pests, like aphids and flies, we are significantly reducing our reliance on conventional pesticides. We're growing these crops using our nutrient film system. This technique precisely controls and recycles water and nutrients. With it, we can produce over 27,000 heads of lettuce a year in this one small area. Some of our best ideas have been inspired by nature, like these fruit and vegetable trees. By growing these ground plants vertically, we can increase yields and better control diseases. These crops taste as good as they look. In fact, we serve more than 15 tons of produce from our greenhouses in restaurants here at the land every year. Agriculture may include innovative ideas like this vertical growing system. Plants grown in this way use a fraction of the space required by traditional growing methods. That saves water and increases production. The aquaponics system on your left combines hydroponics with aquaculture. The fish provide a natural source of fertilizer for the plants, and the plants help keep the water clean for the fish. It's another great way to produce more while using less. In our lab, Epcot scientists are working with the U.S. Department of Agriculture on a number of innovative projects. The goal of these efforts is to produce higher yielding and better quality plants. Being done worldwide to produce bountiful harvests for our growing population. Scientists, farmers, and even backyard gardeners are doing their part to improve the quantity and quality of foods that we all rely upon. Together, we can continue to find more ways to increase food production and protect our precious natural environment.
We'll point you with some important safety information.
When the doors to your flight open, please take a seat and store all carry-on items in the under-seat compartment. This includes cameras, purses, hats, and, of course, these little beauties. Next, fasten your seatbelts, inserting them into the buckle on your right. The smaller aviators don't measure up to the height indicator on the seat. Just put the belt through the loop in the center strap before it buckles.
Yep, got it.
Nice work, pal.
I don't really have much room about
that. Soon you will be airborne. So if you or your little aviators have a fear of flying or of heights, you might want to wait for your party at the arrival. Okay.
No!
Not allowed. I just rode the boat for like 10 times, waiting out the rain. Sun went down a little. This is still Canada?
No, UK.
No, UK's on the other side. There's a big pen.
No.
I saw that.
This is UK.
No, because UK was on the left side.
This map is upside down.
Yeah, but UK is over here.
Yeah, Canada, we just went through it. Now we're in UK. This map is upside down.
Okay.
We're going on this side. That's what I was saying. It's a good thing.
What? What?
Never mind.
It's a good thing what? Tell me the things. I don't understand because you won't watch it.
What?
It's in Doctor Who, okay? You have to watch it. Understand. You don't understand. Hi.
I'm just curious. Biscuit with chocolate favorite filling.
You can do that, yeah.
So why don't you do that so you don't run out of space?
Because I need to use my phone. My phone is dying. I can enjoy France. Dang it. Yeah.
such as Debussy, Ravel, and Camille Saint-Saëns. In just a few seconds, those automatic doors will open toward you, so please remain behind the yellow line, and I would like to know that smoking, eating, drinking, or using flash pictures are not permitted. So, are you ready to go to France?
Oui!
Alors, on y va, c'est parti, bon voyage!
Bon voyage?
On se compagnie.
Non.
The doors located on your left, and please switch off your electronic devices. Thank you. And now, I'm proud to present you a nostalgic visit to my country, La France. I hope you enjoy the classic beauty, music, and romance you will see from Paris to my countryside. Et maintenant, mesdames et messieurs, j'ai le plaisir de vous présenter Impression de France. Bon voyage!
Thank you. the majestic gardens of Versailles, a magic window onto a golden age of kings. an ancient symbol of France. Most ancient. Proud. Full of grace and symmetry. Rooted firmly to the ground, yet dedicated to the spirit. Thank you. all of France, then to celebrate the birth of our Republic.
So we need to go?
We need to pray first.
So we need to go there and then we can come back here and look?
No, let's look around. cerró.
Where are you going? All of the stuff.
What you doing?
Let me write down your four size. Six and a half millimeter. The Big size, same size, perfect for two weeks. Congratulations! Our CC got a beautiful first. Also, it's time to celebrate. Let me be the drum for you. Please clap your hands with a loud round. Yeah. Congratulations, amazing, good choice. Am I happy now?
Yes.
Yes, all right, I will double pick with smiling face for you. Yes. All right, let's clean up your part. This is just regular salt to take off the oyster skin around your part. And salted on it for the first cleaning, no more salt. We have some beautiful jewelry setting for your new part. Please take a moment to look them over in the showcase. ありがとうございました。Thank you very much.
Again.
Subito.
Ciao, welcome.
Do you have $5?
$3,700.
$3,700.
A little more.
like a lot.
No. If it did, I wouldn't be going at this one.
Frozen. One building I remember, of course, is this one. If I remember correctly, this is where it was.
And yes, Donald Duck. No, that's.
Yep, boat cruise. It is exactly the way I remember it.
You put a little bit.
Number of pictures I took of this freaking boat ride because we were stuck in here forever. Oh yeah. I remember taking tons of pictures of that little pyramid.
You got all the angles?
All of them.
Literally all of them.
Well, not all of them, considering it was like one disposable camera, but...
Do you have the pictures?
No, I never got them developed because I lost the film. So I don't even have any pictures.
Sounds fun.
Like I said, the one of me and my dad in front of a blank white wall is the only one.
It's not even in the park.
It is. It's in the gift shop, though.
Sorry, you can't tell. For all I know, that was in the hotel.
Exactly. It's crap. It's like someone forgot the green screen in the Disney World behind us.
Cute Photoshop, like. That was the attraction that put it in the background. That's why.
Yeah, I ain't that skilled yet. And then the little people in the screen will follow at some point. Unless they change.
silent room of the cartoons.
We'll be watching for you. Viva Mexico!
Hey!
That was cute.
What?
He goes, and the owl fly went out.
Thank you.
Not so much France. Only a little bit of France. What crap is this?
Touch tomorrow, take the future.